Hello everybody, this is Andrew Wayne and welcome back to EVE Online. We are on episode 2. Today we're going to go hit up the career agents under the agency tab. We're going to do the Soldier of Fortune mission line. It's going to be 10 missions. We're going to earn a little bit of ISK, get a ship at the end of it. However, I do make two or three really big mistakes in here. Nothing for it, just live it, learn from it, move on. I hope you guys learn from my mistakes, but let's go ahead and get into it.
Your choice of career agent will not limit you in any way. You can choose to work with multiple agents, but let's focus on just one for now. To begin the next phase of what I'm sure will be an illustrious career, accept a mission. Now, let's tidy up our display, shall we? Close the agency and agent conversation windows. Details regarding the mission you accepted from the career agent are displayed on the info panel. Here, you can view the mission briefing, objectives, and rewards. Should you ever need to be reminded of any of those details, you can always check the info panel. I must say, Captain, you've handled yourself remarkably well. Though there are thousands of copies of Aura in New Eden, I am glad to be your Aura. Have I said too much? My sentimentality protocols may need adjusting. Now, it's time for you to venture out into the stars. Go forth and show New Eden what you are truly made of.
Okay, I just wanted to pause it here for a minute. I made a serious mistake, and it is completely 100% my fault. You should always make sure you read the details of the mission before you actually try to do anything. What happened, I did not realize that they had actually given me a catalyst to do this mission on. So I'm about to get my butt handed to me, and nothing I can do about it. So let's go ahead and pick it up and watch this embarrassment and see what happens. Okay, this is where I make my next mistake. On the way back to the base, I was reading the mission description and noticed that they had actually given me another ship, to do for this mission. So as I come back to base, I'm trying to activate the ship, but I can't. And you'll notice that I don't have all the skills needed to fly this ship. So I'm not going to be able to complete the mission at this time because I'm going to have to set up the skills I need to fly the ship. And then I noticed that that's going to take, I believe it was 7 hours or so. So I pretty much decided to call it for the night because it's pretty late my time, for me anyway, and decided to pick it up the next morning. So once I get all this set up for the planning, then I'm going to just basically log off and then I'll pick it back up the next morning. Okay, now it's the next morning. I've slept and I'm logged back in. I'm activating the ship and it starts up. But then I realize I'm not exactly sure what build I should use. Now there's an option in chat for beginner fits. You'll see me looking for it here shortly. And basically I just look up the generic fit for the catalyst. I think that's what this is. And I don't even build the whole thing from the fit because some of the modules and such are not available in this base or whatever you want to call it. So I just load it with the guns and a couple of other items. I figure it's a beginner mission. It's the final one, so it should be fairly easy. But that's what I'm going to do. So you'll see me looking up the new fits, the beginner fits, and then you'll see me doing the best I can with what they have available. And then once I get onto the mission, it actually doesn't take very long to complete it. But that's where I made my mistake yesterday. So learn from my mistakes. Make sure you read your missions carefully and understand what's going on.
Warp drive active. Drive active. Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.